Mixing water with electricity is typically discouraged, and for good reason. But in this project, we're pumping electricity into water with a bit of drain cleaner to create a poor man's power controller. You might have heard of a Variac. This is the Scariac. In a couple of other projects, we fashioned a homemade stick welder using parts we salvaged from old appliances. I powered the device with 240 volts AC, and that was plenty of power, but we still needed a way to adjust the current. I built this device to control alternating current, so we have the ability to play with adjustable power settings on a budget. Now, this concept is about as dangerous as sticking two live wires in a bucket of water. It can be deadly, so it's important to know and understand the risks. To build this Scariac, we'll need a 4-gallon container to hold our electrolyte, and I like this one because it's got a lid that snaps on tight. I cut a piece of board so that it measures at 16 inches by 14 inches because that fits on top, leaving a 3-inch overhang on the side. I made this plastic template for marking holes for where the switch and outlet will go, and a few other markings based on these measurements. To cut the holes out, let's drill the corners first, then use a jigsaw to cut the sides. We can use the light switch as a template for marking where the two holes will need to be drilled. This part is optional, but let's go ahead and finish the edges with a 1/2-inch rounding bit on the router table. By profiling the tops and bottoms of all the edges, we're left with a nice smooth finish. Next we'll need two pieces of 2x2, and I had these ones left over from when we made our mousetrap handguns, which you can see in a different project. I drilled a hole through the sides of the blocks 1/2 inch from the top, and cut them down to 1 1/4 inches so they look like this. These blocks will need to be secured flush with the top of the center hole, so let's trace the edges and drill 4 pilot holes on diagonals. They'll eventually be held in place with screws from the bottom side. I gave these parts a paint job, and now the panel board is complete and we can move on to constructing the power lever. All the parts for the power lever are laid out here, and you can see they're mainly 1/2-inch PVC parts, as well as these other miscellaneous bits of hardware. Now we can get to work priming and cementing the PVC together so that we end up with 2 sections that look like this. They'll be fit together later on, but here you can get a basic idea of how it's going to work. We'll need to mark and drill a hole right through the lower part of the T, then make the hole bigger on the inner sides. The hole has to be just big enough to allow the head of a 2.5-inch bolt to pass through. Here you can see I added a metal washer and a beveled rubber washer on the inside. At this point, the two parts of the handle can be cemented together and the excess glue wiped away. I decided to paint the handle red to give it a nice contrast against the black. We can add a rubber washer to the bolt first, and the block gets pushed on next until you see about 1/4 inch of the bolt poking out on the end. I added a washer and a wing nut to hold it in place, and now we have the ability to adjust the tension on the power lever. Now that our blocks are attached, let's push the bottom part of the handle through the hole and secure the blocks to the board using the screws we lined up earlier. At this point, we're ready to wire up the electrical, and this is how it's going to look when it's finished. I started with 2 17-inch pieces of 1/2-inch copper tubing. Let's make 4 markings at 3, 4.5, 12.5, and 14 inches. That should leave us with an 8-inch gap between the middle markings. Now we can use a hammer or bench vise to compress the copper, allowing us to bend it over easily. When all the markings have been compressed, including the tips, the electrode can be formed into a rectangle and should look like this. I've drilled a hole through the center of the tips, continuing into the tube itself, but only through one side of it. For this electrode, let's add a 4-inch plastic PVC riser so that it lines up flush with one of the edges. Then we can put a screw right through it so it's held between the two pieces of copper. The other end of this riser can screw into the bottom of our power lever, making sure the copper bar is facing forward. The other 4-inch riser gets added into the power lever and can be secured to the copper as well. To form the second electrode holder, I added a PVC cap to a 6-inch PVC riser and used a belt sander to grind away at the top until it was completely flat. With the power lever in the full upright position, we can get a feel for where the longer risers will need to be attached. Using 2 screws for each riser, we can bite down into the riser caps, securing them in position. Now the second electrode can be added, adjusting it so it's the same height as the first, and of course 2 more screws will fix the copper in place. Now it's time to rig up the wiring for this contraption. I've got some 12-gauge cable and a 2-prong plug. The plug opens up, allowing us to connect our two wires, and screws back together, completing this end of the cable. The black wire from the cable runs to the light switch first, and connects to the screw on the far side. The wire is cut and connected to the other screw on the switch, then continues to this hole drilled through the board. On the top side, you can see the wire is bent over in an arch and goes back through the board, where it continues to the electrode on the power lever. The electrode wire can simply be connected by looping it behind the existing screw and fastening tight. Let's use another piece of the black wire and connect it to the other electrode in the same way. You can see this wire connects to the outlet and gets held on with one of the gold screws. This silver screw is connected to the white wire running from the cable, and this completes our electrical work. At this point, we can fasten the light switch and the outlet onto the control board and add the face plates for a finishing touch. This control panel is fully functional, but if you wanted to add a little more safety, you could add a replaceable fuse or even wire up a circuit breaker. To finish up the system, we'll just need to modify this lid. We can use a rotary tool with a cutting wheel to cut along the inner edges, leaving just the rim intact. The inside hole has to be large enough to allow both electrodes to fit in freely, and when it's centered on the top, we can screw together the four corners so it's all attached. This way, it clamps into position perfectly every time. I wanted to add a piece of trim around the power lever, so I stopped at the grocery store and picked up a container of bean dip. The empty container is exactly the right size, and with just a little cutting and two pieces of double-sided sticky tape, it mounts right behind the power lever. Our last step is to mix the electrolyte. I'm using about 2 gallons of tap water, and that fills the container up halfway. To make the water more conductive, we'll be using this crystal drain cleaner because it's 100% lye. This stuff is so dangerous and so potent that we'll only need 1/4 teaspoon mixed into the entire solution. Now we can secure the control board in place, connect the plug to a power source, and test it out. Let's make sure the power lever is pushed fully forward before the switch is turned on. Now the system is powered, and you can see that if we gently pull the lever back, the light begins to glow dimly. And if we pull it all the way back, it increases to full intensity. The switch is a kill switch, and will cut the power to the system in an instant. The main purpose of this contraption is to regulate current to our electrical devices. Adding just a little power to an angle grinder will cause the device to spin very slowly. But pulling back on the lever will increase the power until it reaches full speed. The control panel has this loop of black wire that allows us to monitor the amperage in high power applications, like the arc welding project. You can see that if we pull back on the lever, the current climbs higher. An interesting observation is that the voltage is pretty much constant through the entire cycle. The system can handle extremely high electrical loads, and in contrast, it can also make a table saw turn at a snail's pace. Pushing forward on the lever increases the electrolytic resistance, and as a result, the equipment slows down or comes to a full stop. Well, now you know you can control electricity with water and a bit of drain cleaner. Remember that this has the power to kill you, and that's why it's called the Scariac. If you like this project, perhaps you'll like some of my others. Check them out at thekingofrandom.com.